We're at the Pavilion Gardens in Buxton, where the High Peak's new walk-in coronavirus testing site is now based. One of these centres will be in each district and borough across Derbyshire in a bid to reduce the number of positive COVID-19 cases in the community. We've been to take a look inside and take a test so you can see the process for yourself. Keep watching to find out more. We're joined by Mandy, one of the team leaders here at the High Peak coronavirus testing site. Mandy, first of all, tell us what your role is.
Yes, hi Adam. My role here is one of five team leaders running this site. We're open 7 days a week and we're based here in the centre of Buxton in these beautiful Pavilion Gardens. So it's a lovely chance for people to come and see the venue as well.
How many staff have been involved in the running of the site and day to day? How have they been involved in it?
At the moment, we've got, because of the numbers of people that we've got coming in every day from the public, we've got about 16 people here. We're split into two teams. We've got one team running the site, welcoming everybody, taking details, making everybody feel comfortable, putting people at their ease. And then we've got the other team of testing operatives who are actually helping the public to carry out their tests and giving them some guidance on whatever they need help with.
It's quite a big process as well. It's been quite a big operation, hasn't it? And staff have been trained to sort of get involved in the process. How's that been? How's everyone been adapting to their roles?
Oh, it's been fabulous. We've got people here from all walks of life, from all age groups. We want people to represent the community here. So lots of people who've come from different jobs, who already work for the council in a different capacity, or people who've been furloughed or made redundant. Who are all people, you know, like myself, who just want to make a contribution and do something for the community and help the local people of Buxton and the surrounding areas.
So this is the High Peak's coronavirus testing site. So how important is it that people all over the High Peak come and get a test?
We welcome everybody, so anybody from the High Peak area, as long as this is local to where they live and obviously respects the current restrictions of movement, anybody's welcome to come for a test, providing that they don't have any symptoms. That's one of the most important things. They have to be asymptomatic. You don't have to book in advance. It's a drop-in centre.
People who work in the High Peak can come and get a test as well, not just residents of the High Peak.
No, definitely not. No, we're all open to all age groups. If you've got anybody who is under 16, who needs or wants a test, they have to be accompanied by a parent or a guardian who is happy to give their consent and help them with the test. 17 and 18 year olds, providing that they're happy to do the test themselves, they can come along. And adults, obviously, of all ages, we can help people, but we're not allowed to actually do the test with you. You have to be able to do the test yourself. But we do have facilities here for everybody to come from the local area. And we can help with whatever people need help with.
How many people have you been testing so far on average every day?
We've been very pleased actually, because the centre's only been open for a couple of days, so word's obviously getting out and about. And we've had 300 people over the 2 days, and we've only had two positive tests, so that's a fabulous number. So we'd like to reassure the public that this is a safe place to come, and that all strict hygiene measures are in place for any positive tests that we do get. So it's a very, very safe place, stringent measures, and people can be reassured that they can come here. And as I say, we welcome members from the public. If you're retired, if you're furloughed, made redundant, and also we do encourage people to come if you're working, whether you're a tradesman or if you're working in a supermarket or in a medical capacity, you can also come and have repeat tests.
And how often should people be coming to get a test, do you think?
I think it depends. You can also come if you've had the vaccine, so that's not a problem either. Some people may have had the vaccine, but they haven't had their full 3 weeks immunity yet. We have some people at other centres who are coming on a weekly basis. If they're working in supermarkets, we've had teams of electricians and plumbers who their employers would like them to come on a weekly basis if they're going into people's houses for work purposes. So that's the norm is once a week if you're, but you can come more often than that if you need to. And again, to reassure the public, we are tested every single morning. So the staff come in an hour earlier before the site opens to the public, and just to check that every single member of staff tests negative before we open the doors.
What's your message for people who perhaps feel a bit apprehensive about coming to get a test?
It's very understandable. I was even apprehensive when I did my first one. It's a strange scenario because you have to put a swab in the back of your throat and up your nostril. But I think people do get used to it. Now I've done mine several days, it's not as bad as you might think it is. But there's a lovely friendly team here, everybody knows the situation, everybody knows how you feel because they're doing their daily tests. So we're just here to help with a smile and a joke and put you at your ease and make it as painless an experience as possible.
And do people have to bring anything with them on the day when they come for a test?
They don't have to bring anything in terms of ID or anything like that, but if you have got a smartphone and you're comfortable using it and you know how to use it, that would help. Because that encourages you to register yourself when you get here. You don't have to register in advance. You're given a registration card with a barcode on it. If you're not happy or comfortable using a mobile phone to register yourself, there are people with tablets and we can help you go through that registration process. So that's the first thing you do when you get here, and then you're obviously walked through the rest of the procedure, which in total only takes about 10-15 minutes, and then you're good to go.
And people who don't have a smartphone don't have to worry either, do they?
No, you don't need a phone at all, actually. The phone number is obviously to register when you get your results. That will be texted to you in about 30 minutes. And if you don't have a mobile phone or a phone number, then you can leave an email address as well. So, and then the result will be emailed to you.
And if people get the result and it comes back positive, what should they do then?
In the very rare, as I say, we've only had a couple so far, in the very rare event that there is a positive test, you will be emailed with that result, lots of instructions about what to do next and what your course of action is. Obviously, from that moment, you need to self-isolate and make sure you're following all the rules that have already been stipulated by the government and the NHS. And you would ring 119 and ask for a home testing kit and make sure that you're advising then people you've come into contact with who've tested positive.
And how are the tests actually carried out as well?
When you are directed to a bay, you'll be asked to just blow your nose first, and then you'll be given a swab, which is basically, it's like a long cotton wool board on a stick. So you will use the test yourself. You pop the swab onto each tonsil. So you'll circle it around each tonsil for 5 seconds on either side. You'll then take that swab out of your mouth and you'll pop it at one nostril and you'll turn it in your nostril for about 10 seconds. You'll then put that swab into a little test tube, which the test operative has, and it will then be mixed with some fluid and then put onto a sample. And as soon as that sample has started to process the test, the test operative will let you know that the test's working and that you can go. And then it's put behind where the test operative section is, and it's left for 30 minutes, and then the results recorded within 30 minutes.
Is there anything else you think people should know about before they come to get a test?
Well, we're a lovely, friendly bunch down here, and we're all here to help with the community with whatever they need. We've had a lovely response from everybody so far. We've had lots of people coming, and they've all mentioned that it wasn't as bad as they thought it was going to be. So, as I say, there's 5 different people here running the team. There's lots of lovely, friendly locals. There might even be some people down here that you know or that you work with. We'd like to encourage local businesses and supermarkets and other employers in the area to encourage their employees to come if they're working, if they can't work from home. But we'd just love to see you. So do come on down and say hello and spread the word.
Thanks so much, Mandy.
Thanks very much, Adam. So, once you've registered at the entrance, you'll then be directed to another colleague who will take some basic information details, and then you'll be shown through to the testing area.
Phone number.
Yeah.
So, welcome to the site. I'm just going to talk you through the different stages. It's a very quick process. So here I am at the entrance, where you will be given a registration card by one of our chaperones. You are encouraged to log in and register yourself if you have a mobile phone. If you don't, or you're not happy registering yourself, we have people here who can help you with this registration process. So, in the testing area, we have 10 bays to welcome our members of the public, and each bay is monitored by a testing operative who will go through the process with you. It's a very quick, simple and easy procedure, and there are diagrams to help you, and all of the staff are on hand to give you guidance in carrying out the test yourself if you need some help. So once you've had your test, you'll then be guided by one of our chaperones to the exit, where another colleague will thank you for coming and offer you a card should you need to come back for another test.
So around half an hour after taking my test, I've just received my result, and thankfully it's come back negative. The process is very quick and simple. Even if you don't have a smartphone, the site is open 7 days a week and you don't have to book. The message to the community is come and use it.